As soon as we got our Mavic Mini 2, we got on a plane and flew to Arizona, where it's always really, really sunny, and we really needed to get some ND grad filters. That means neutral density, which means it doesn't affect your colors, it just makes it darker. And so we were lucky to get these ones, or here's the Mavic that we're using. And for it, we got filters by this company Freewheel, and they give you a really nice package with several options. So you have your whole box here, and you have a bunch of filters, including circular polarizers or just the ND, and they come in grades. And that is a really good thing because the sun is not constant, so you really need to know which ones to use. And they come with a little booklet which tells you in what conditions to use what filter. For example, in full sun it tells you ND16, and in kind of a middle overcast condition, not really all the way but kind of see-through sun, you get the ND8, and for the sake of overcast you get the ND4 filter. And we experimented in the last week with those filters in different conditions out here in the desert and around, and I have to say it really makes a very big difference for the sake of your image quality when it comes down to correcting that light, because in the sky there's always too much light and there's always glare and all these things. And we got them sometimes a little wrong, and that's okay because it was a test. And we saw that indeed when you don't get the right filter on, like we hit ND4 in full sun yesterday, and it did blow out the picture a bunch, and you see it visibly degrade the image quality. So with the drone, if you want to get the optimal image quality, you always want to have ND filters. And beyond that, if you're shooting things like water or highly reflective surfaces, you want to get the circular polarizer. And this company is good because they combine the two and you get circular polarizer and ND in the same package. And some people also like to get into the long exposure photography with a drone of landscapes you cannot get any other way. And for that, they make you very dark filters like ND 1000 and 2000. So you can use them for things like rivers and waterfalls and so on. And they offer that as well. So we're practicing with all of them. I'm really quite happy with them, and they do visibly give you a better image quality. So we shot a lot of clips, and we'll show you a little bit of tips from the field and some of these clips of how they came out from shooting out here in Arizona with them. So these filters that we got by a company called Freewheel for the DJI Mini 2 came with a little booklet that tells you on an overcast day like today, use the grade 4, and I have the 16, which is for full sunlight. So I really appreciate it, they give you that. And there's 18 for sparse kind of clouds. So now I'm gonna switch it from 16 to 4, since last time we flew it, it was full sun. And hopefully it stays on. And I know how to figure it out. I was still nervous messing with this because it's right by the gimbal that is super fine electronics. And the way you do that, it has a little vent and you latch it onto the vent. It's pretty funny. And here, come on. See, it's super small and fine, which is kind of crazy. Used to be the Mavic's battery themselves could tell you whether they're charged and how much, but this one you have to have the charger and you insert it and then it starts lighting up right here on the charger. So it's a portable nice charger where it will tell you. So now I know it's this one. You always want your top most filled battery to fly because you don't want to run out and lose your drone. You don't want to launch with like even half, in my opinion. Maybe under half is really just not worth it and a bad idea. Not a very long setup, but there is some setup time with a drone. Because of that, it's not like run and gun like with a GoPro. You have to premeditate and you have to dedicate some time
So what do we have on here for ND?
We have a 4, which is exactly what I want.
Because it's kind of golden hour, it's the end of the day. We don't need a full sun. ND is because when there's in the sky, it's always bright. It's always too much light almost. Even when it's overcast, you're not used to seeing up there. You're down here where there's less light. And up there, there's glare and all kinds of stuff. So it's always brighter than you want it to be, pretty much. So what you do is you use the darker glass and it becomes okay, like sunglasses, really. Yeah, let's hope none of the ducks attack the drone. We're ready for takeoff.
Are we?
Yeah, we are. Hope no, we're not, silly.
Where's your phone?
Exactly. Takeoff permitted. We have been blessed. Now we're ready for takeoff.
Such interesting geography. Oop, that was filter. This filter doesn't stay. I don't know how exactly. Yeah, it's already scratched now.
That's a bummer.
Yeah, and it don't latch as well as you would hope. So it just fell off right into the rock and got scratched. It may or may not get into the picture. We'll see. This is just the reality of taking gear out to the field.
Yeah.
It's really.
You drop it, you lose it, you scratch it.
Yeah.
You forget it. It happens all the time.
Oh, these are the big ones that they sent us. It's like ND 1000 and 2000 for long exposure photography. This is the fun part, going out in nature, taking the drone out. Thank you.